In this next short film, we're going to talk about how to look after flowers once you've got them into the vase. As you can imagine, some flowers will die before others. And the best way to maintain the vase life is to trim out anything that's died. You can either pick it out or you can trim it, say like this. You just cut back to the base and you can just remove it. Now, the most important reason we're doing this is because dying flowers produce a gas called ethylene, and it actually prematurely ages the other flowers, so it's a good thing to get rid of them. The other thing you can do is to change the water regularly. Changing the water is a good thing, because as you can imagine, bacteria builds up in the water, which helps to rot everything and makes a bad smell. So that way it'll just help to keep everything fresh. Interestingly, the other produce that produces ethylene gas is fruit. So don't place your flowers near to fruit if you want a long vase life. The other thing not to do is to put them anywhere that's too warm, in bright sunshine, near a radiator, and most importantly, don't put anything that's got water on top of anything electrical, on top of a stereo or a television or anything like that. And it's really important to take it out of the water bubble and put it into a vase. Rose stems can sometimes, the heads of at least, can sometimes tip over like this, just bend or completely bend right round. And this is because an airlock is formed in the stem. This is a woody stem. So what we need to do is, you can either plunge it into tap hot water, really hot water, or we can do the boiling water, which I'm about to demonstrate to you now. So I'm just going to go off and get a kettle of boiling water. Here's the boiling water. Be careful not to use anything that's glass or breakable, or probably even metal actually, because if you pick it up it'll be hot. So use something plastic. And you only need to pour in about 5 centimetres, that's probably about enough. And then take your rose and give it a fresh cut, and then put it into the boiling water for about 30 seconds. You can leave it there. And then you need to transfer it into cold water, into deep cold water. So once that's been in there for 30 seconds, it's been about 30 seconds, so remove the stem, recut again, and then plunge it into cold water, and then leave it in the cold water, and it should perk up. It should have given it enough force to push up that air bubble or something, and then the head will straighten up. Going on from putting the bouquet into a vase, like I showed you just earlier, and having or thinking about what vases you should have in the home, I've also got some other ideas in what you can do within the home while you're not using it or while you are using it. Now, you might remember I saved the cellophane from the bubble of water. And this is really handy because you can, if for instance you get some flowers and they're too short and you only have a big vase, you could use the cellophane and scrunch it inside like so, and it provides a bit of a lift for the flowers so it doesn't look like they're just floating in water. The other thing you can use to put into the bottom of the vase, like the big pebbles that I've used here, is these smaller pebbles or gravel, anything like this. You can use, these come in different colours. We've got a buff colour here and a aubergine purple, which is very nice. And you can use them to either complement your room, your interior, or the flowers that you've received. They're really good, they work very well. They might need a little rinse because they're a bit dusty, but use anything you like. As I mentioned, shells or pebbles you've picked up, anything. As long as it's clean and doesn't discolour the water and looks pretty in the vase.